to do when all I can is thinking about you. Today we are going to discuss the concepts and definitions of what a differential equation is all about. Okay, so for the concepts and definitions, we have this differential equation denoted by this DE, contains at least one derivative, and most often it is written in terms of differentials. Okay, so take note of this one, at least one derivative, and it is written in terms of differentials. Okay, so I think you are very familiar with this derivative, no? And what this derivative is all about. And also, if you have a derivative, so we also have now these differentials. And this differential equation may be ordinary or partial differential equation as to the type of derivatives or differentials appearing in the equation. So here we have an example of what a differential equation is all about. Okay, so we have here in number one, dy over dx is equal now to cosine x. Okay, and we sometimes write this one as equivalent to this one. Okay, the derivative d over dx of your variable y is equal now to cosine x. Okay, so the derivative of your y with respect to x is equal now to cosine x, and it is the same as this one, dy over dx is equal now to cosine x. Okay, and you can read this one as the derivative also of your y with respect to x is equal to cosine x. Okay, I hope this is clear to you now. And for the second one, we have now this second derivative of your y with respect to x plus k squared y equal to 0. So as you can see, it involves also derivatives, but in this case we have this second derivative because of this numbers of this number. So it refers now to the order of your derivative actually. So you can read this one as the second derivative of y with respect to x, while this one is the derivative of y with respect to x, or just equivalent to the first derivative of y with respect to x, because here it is absolutely one here, also here a power of one. Okay, so we have also now this number three, x squared plus y squared quantity dx minus 2xy dy is equal to 0. So as long as you have now this equation, you can express this one as this form, dy over dx. So in what way? So you are going to multiply this equation by 1 over dx. So its result will then be x squared plus y squared. So you multiply 1 over dx here, you distribute this one, so this will eliminate, no, cancel out this dx, and this one will be minus 2xy, and then you have now this dy, since you multiply this one with 1 over dx, so dy over dx is equal to 1 over dx times 0 is just equal now to 0. So you have now this form already, no? This dy over dx, or the derivative of your y with respect to x. So since it contains at least one derivative, so in this case at least one derivative, so it is also called a differential equation. Number 4, we have also now this first term, no? The second derivative of your y with respect to t plus the second derivative of your x with respect to t is equal now to x. So it involves also a derivative. So all of these four examples are considered as differential equations because of this criteria. At least one derivative, and it involves also in terms of differentials. So as you can see here, a DE may be ordinary or partial. So as you can see in number 1, this is ordinary differential equation. In number 2, ordinary. And also for the number 3 and 4 are all ordinary differential equations. So later you will see what is this partial differential equation is all about. So in our further slides, you will get acquainted to this partial differential equation. So proceeding with our next slide, we have now this order. Sorry. So what is this order is all about? So you must be familiar with this. And by definition, the order of the differential equation is the order of the highest order derivative. Take note, when you consider now what order is the differential equation, take note of this one, it is the highest ordered derivative appearing in the equation or equations. So we have also an example for this. For this number 1, we have this dy over dx is equal now to cosine x. So what is now its highest order derivative? So this is just the only term, no, involving a derivative, which is dy over dx. So actually it is absolutely here, it is considered as 1 here, also here as unity. But since when a variable or a number raised to a unity is just equal to that variable, so that is why it is written as dy over dx. So in this case, the order of the differential equation is first, this is first order. Okay, so we will write here this one as first order differential equation. Okay, so how about the other example here? You have now this second derivative of y with respect to x plus k squared y equal to 0. So what order is this? What order is this? Okay, since our derivative is this term, okay, and it is the highest order derivative, so its highest order derivative in this equation is only this one, which is now this 2, okay, meaning the second derivative. So therefore it is a second order derivative. Okay, second order derivative, differential equation. Okay, so how about the number 3 here? How will you determine its order? So actually here, same as what we did, no, in our previous slide, we can write this one, no, into dy over dx. Okay, so we just have to multiply this one with 1 over dx. Okay, so this is equal now to x squared plus y squared quantity. This one will cancel out, and then you 1 over dx times this one minus 2xy. Then we have now this dy over dx, since 1 over dx times this term, and this would be equal now to 0 times 1 over dx, which is equal to 0. So we are now concerned here, since we have to determine what order is the derivative. So in this case, it is just a first order because it involves only the first derivative of your variable y or of your y with respect to x. Okay, so this is now a first order differential equation. Okay, so how about this one, the number, for example, the second derivative of y with respect to t plus the second derivative of x with respect to t, again equal to x. So this one is a derivative, also as the second term is also the derivative, and its highest derivative is 2, since they are all the same, no? Here is 2, the second derivative also here, so therefore it is a second order differential equation. Okay, so how about this number 5? So actually we have now this one in a derivative form and also this in a derivative form. So we are concerned what is the highest order derivative. So here this is a first order now, because this is only a derivative of your w with respect to x, but this one is the third derivative of your w with respect to x. So we are considering this as the highest order derivative. So therefore we can say that this equation is a third order derivative. Okay, and lastly we have this number 6. So y double prime plus 2y prime minus 8y is equal to x squared plus cosine x. So actually we can write this one, no? If you are not yet familiar with this one, actually your y prime is just equal now to dy over dx. Okay, and your y double prime is just equal now to your second derivative of your y with respect now to x. Okay, so therefore this is just equivalent to second derivative of your y with respect now to x plus 2 dy over dx minus 8y is equal to x squared plus cosine x. Okay, so we are now concerned here this one. So this is a derivative also, but we need to determine what is the highest derivative. So since this is now the highest derivative, no, since this is the second derivative of your y with respect to x again, so therefore we can say that this is a second order derivative or differential equation. Okay, I hope this is clear now to everyone and to everybody now what is the order of the differential equation is all about. So you need only to consider its derivative, no, and what is now its highest derivative, meaning what is now the highest number of your derivative, where in this case we can determine the order in each of these examples. So proceeding, for our next slide we have now this degree. So what is this degree of differential equation? So by definition, it is the power or exponent to which the derivative of the highest order in the equation or equations are raised. Okay, so I think this is very apparent and quite visible, no? That after determining the derivative of the highest order, we have to look into its power or exponent, and that is how to determine the degree of your differential equation. So previously, you have to know the order, the highest derivative, no, of in the equation, and after you determine the highest derivative, just look into its power exponent and you can determine its degree. So here we have an example. Again, for these are 6 examples. Dy over dx equals to cosine x. So what is now its highest order derivative? So this is the only derivative, no? Dy over dx. So what is now its power or exponent? So it is understandably raised to the 1. So this is therefore a first degree. Okay, since this is now our highest order derivative, dy over dx, so it is raised just to the exponent or power 1, so this is a first degree. How about this second example? So we determined already that the order of this differential equation is second order. So what is now the exponent of this second order differential equation? So actually its exponent is just simply, this is just equivalent to, actually this is just the same as putting here like this raised to the 1. It's just simply as that. So its power exponent is just simply raised to the 1. So this is again a first degree. Okay, first degree differential equation. So how about this number 3? What is now its degree? Since we already rewrite this one in this form. Okay, sorry. We need to erase this one. So since we already rewrite this one into this form, x squared plus y squared minus 2xy dy over dx is equal to 0. So this one is the only highest order derivative, no? Since this is the only term that involves a derivative, so it's just the same as this one, no? In our number 1, so example number 1, so it is also a first degree. This is also a first degree differential equation. Okay, how about this one, number 4? So its highest order derivative is also the term 1 and the term 2, and also their power or exponent is just raised now to the 1. So therefore it is a first degree. Okay, how about this number 5? So we already knew that this is now the highest order derivative, no? The third derivative of your w with respect to x. So what is now its exponent or power? So it is raised now to this number. Okay, so therefore we can say that this is a second degree. Okay, second degree differential equation. Also this one, we already rewrite this one into in terms of your dy over dx. Okay, so this is second derivative of your y with respect now to x plus 2. We have now this derivative of y with respect to x minus 8y is just equal to x squared plus cosine x. So we are concerned to this term, the second derivative of y, and still it is raised now to a power or exponent of 1. So therefore it is a first degree differential equation. Okay, so that is all about the degree of our differential equation. So proceeding again with our next slide, we have now this solution and what is a general solution and consequently particular solution. Okay, the solution to a differential equation is the relation involving only the variables and arbitrary constants. Okay, so it involves variables and the arbitrary constants, and it is also free of any derivatives or differentials and consistent with or satisfying the given DE. So take note, this is now the solution involving only the variables and arbitrary constants. So how about if these variables, especially these arbitrary constants, have a value already? Okay, how about if that situation happened? So this would be now the case for a particular solution in which here our arbitrary constants are already having these values, and these values may be obtained from a certain boundary conditions. Okay, so by definition, a general solution of a differential equation of the nth order contains n arbitrary constants. If particular values are assigned to these arbitrary constants, normally in our future problem applications and calculations, this is denoted by variable C. The solution is called a particular solution if a particular values are already assigned to these arbitrary constants through this boundary or given boundary conditions. So actually, I have an example, no, of this one to make it clear to you what is and how to do it, no, in calculating the solution. And later, no, in our further topics, we can proceed with the general solution, the particular solution using the boundary conditions. Okay, so we have here an example, no, we are going to verify that y is equal now to e raised to the 2x is a solution of the equation given. So this is now our equation, the second derivative of your y with respect to x plus the derivative of your y with respect to x minus 6y is equal to 0. So here you are going to determine, since our derivatives involve the first derivative of your y with respect to x and also involve the second derivative of your y with respect to x, so you have to determine this dy over dx and this second derivative of y with respect to x. So first we have this given equation. Okay, so here we have y is equal now to e raised now to the 2x. Okay, so first you are going to determine the dy over dx, okay? Since this is our dy over dx. And later, we are going to determine this second derivative. So here, we have y is equals to e raised to the 2x. So our derivative, no, d over dx of your y, which is just equal now to dy over dx, is equal now to this e to the 2x times the derivative with respect to x of your exponent here, 2x. Okay? I hope you still remember, no, your integral calculus. Why is this form? So here, actually, I would like to remind you, no, that actually we have this here. Since our derivative d over dx of your e raised to the u is equal to e to the u times your d over dx of your u. Okay? So actually this is now a property, no, in integral calculus, that when you get the derivative of e raised to the u is just equal now to e to the u itself times the derivative of your power or exponent, which is in this case the u. Okay? So that is why here, getting now the derivative of this one, our u here is 2x. So that's why e to the u here, e to the 2x, then times d over dx, or the derivative with respect to x of your u, where our u here is 2x. So therefore, we can say that our dy over dx is equal to e raised now to the 2x times the derivative of your 2x is just the 2, okay? It's just simply equal to 2. Or therefore, we can say that your dy over dx is equal now to 2 times a raised to the 2x. So here, we can have now this dy over dx is equal to 2 times e raised now to the 2x. Okay? So we have to indicate this one, because later we will use this one and also this one, which is given, no, because we have also y here. So we already get y, the dy over dx here. So all we need to determine now is to determine the second derivative of your y with respect now to x. Okay? So here we are going to determine now the second derivative. Okay, so number two is determine the second derivative of your y with respect now to your x. Okay, so actually we have here, since our dy over dx is equal now to 2 times e raised to the 2x. So we can say that our second derivative of your y with respect now to x is just equal now to 2 times d over dx of your this one, e raised to the 2x, plus again this e to the 2x raised to the 2x times the derivative of your 2, this one. Okay, so as you can see here, the derivative of a number, no, of a constant is just equal now to 0, so only this term remains. Okay, so we have now the second derivative of your y with respect now to x is just equal now to 2 times the derivative of e to the 2x is just same here, okay? E to the u, okay? E to the u times derivative of your u. So here, e to the u, which is 2x times the derivative of your u, where it is the derivative of 2x, which is 2, okay? So therefore, we can say that your second derivative of y with respect to x is just equal now to 4 times e raised to the 2x, okay? So this would be now our second derivative, okay? So proceeding, so I think we need to have some space here for us to proceed. And we will erase some part here, okay? So since we already know y is just equal now to e raised to the 2x, so we have now this one. So therefore, from this equation, if we substitute this second derivative of y with respect to x, this one, which is equal now to 4 times e raised to the 2x. So we can say that your second derivative of your y with respect now to x plus your dy over dx minus 6y is just equal to 0, okay? So substituting, okay, so your second derivative is this value, 4 times e raised to the 2x, 4 times a raised to the 2x plus your first derivative is 2 times e raised to the 2x minus 6 times your y is just equal now to 2x, okay? E raised to the 2x is just equal to 0, in which you sum up these two is 6 times e raised to the 2x minus 6 times e raised to the 2x, this is just equal now to 0. So this is okay. So therefore, we can say, we can say that your y is equal now this e raised to the 2x is a solution. Is a solution of the equation this equation. Second derivative of your y with respect now to x plus dy over dx minus 6y equal to 0. So we have already calculated and verified that this y equals to e raised now to the power of 2x is a solution of this given differential equation. Okay, so proceeding now with our next slide. Okay, so we have now this independent and dependent variables. Okay, so when an equation involves one or more derivatives with respect a particular variable, that variable is called the independent variable. So take note, with respect to a particular variable, okay? And that variable, this variable is called the independent variable. So actually, this variable is referring now to this variable, okay? So by definition, involves one or more derivatives with respect to a particular variable. So that variable which is referring now to this particular variable is called the independent variable. So I will show you here example now for this differential equation. Dy over dx is equals to 2x. Example. So by this, you read this one as the this is read as the derivative of y with respect to variable x. Okay, so this is now the proper description or reading of this term. Dy over dx is just read as the derivative of y, in which this one, which is equivalent to, these are just equivalent to, as what I've said no before, this one is equals to 2x. The derivative of your y with respect now to variable x is equal to 2x, which is just equal to or equivalent to this dy over dx is equal to 2x. So that is why we can read this one as like this, since this is now the derivative, okay? So that is why the derivative of y, in which this is now your y, the derivative no of y with respect to variable x, this one in the denominator no of this d over dx. So this variable here below no below here is what we call now the independent variable. So with this one, with respect to a particular variable, so this one with respect to variable x, so this is the same as or synonymous to this expression, no? To this phrase, with respect to a particular variable, this one is with respect to variable x, so this is called now the independent variable. Okay, I hope this is clear now to all of you. So that is why if in this example, no, number one and number two, so all those variable located here, no, here below that this one with this derivative, no, so this is called the independent variable. And on the other hand, this dependent variable is a variable if a derivative of that variable occurs, meaning this variable is referring to, this variable is referring now to this variable, okay? So I hope this is clear to all of you. A variable, if a derivative of that variable occurs, so this variable is referring now to this independent variable, is called the dependent variable, okay? So we have here in this example number one, so our independent variable here is our t, okay? Our variable t is our independent variable, okay? So we can say that here your t is just equal now to your independent variable, okay? While your I here, located here, no, is your I is your dependent variable. Okay? So T here is that independent variable, and your I is called now your dependent variable. In our equation number 2, you have here our independent variable R. We have 2 actually. Our independent variable R, X and Y. This is now our independent variables. Okay? Since we have here a X, also here we have Y. So X and Y, we have 2 independent variables. And actually, we have only 1 dependent variable, which is our V. This is now our dependent variable. Okay? So I think this is very clear to everyone, no? What is this dependent and independent variable are all about? Okay? So proceeding, we have to determine also as our first topic, no? In our subject differential equation, since all of those previously discussed, no, in our previous slides were just simple illustration for concepts and definitions, but this time we are going to tackle what is linear and nonlinear differential equation. Okay, so here we have this ordinary differential equation. Okay, so as defined, an ordinary differential equation of order n is called linear if it may be written in the form indicated here. Okay? So as you can observe, we have now this b sub o as a function of your x times the nth derivative, no? We consider n, no, as our derivative here, nth derivative of y with respect to x, plus, since this is bo or our b initial, so this would be our b sub 1 as a function also of x. Since this is a function of x, so this is also a function of x. Times the derivative, no? As you can observe, your n here is you just have to decreasing actually. So if you have 5 here, the next one should be 4 because n minus 1. The next term should be 3. 2 and 1 and so on until you arrive to this last term, b sub n as a function of x times y is equal to r as a function of x. So in this case, since we are considering n, so n, this one n minus 1, so it will simply implies, no, that our third term here is b sub 2 as a function of x. Then you have also this, if you are going to determine, no, the third, no, the third term, if you are going to determine now the third term is just simply, since this is now our first, no, this would be now our first term, our second, so what would be now our third? Okay, so our third term will be b subscript 2 as a function of x, then times this derivative, no, the n minus 2, since this is n minus 1, next is n minus 2 of y over dx n minus 2. Okay, so our fourth term here is just simply as b subscript 3 as a function of x, okay, times this derivative of n minus 3 derivative of y over dx raised to the n minus 3, okay, and so on and so forth. So until you reach this b subscript n minus 1 as a function of x. So, dy over dx, no, until this order of your differential or of your derivative reaches 1, no, raised to the 1, or dy over dx plus bn as a function of x times y equals to r over x. So kindly familiarize this this one, since this is the criterion, no? This is the criterion of determining if your ordinary differential equation of order n is called linear. Otherwise, if it doesn't follow this equation, it is called non-linear, as here, non-linear. Okay? So proceeding. We have now this next slide. So we have here linearity if extended to partial. Take note, partial differential equation. So if you encounter, no, if you encounter a symbol, no, like this, this is just simply the meaning of this partial differential equation. Okay, if this is D, example, this one is D, excuse me, if that would be written as this one, B subscript O as a function of x, y, and then we have now this d omega over d dx. So this is just a sign, no, if this is an ordinary, okay, ordinary differential equation. But if you encounter this symbol, no, this is just referring to this partial differential equation. So kindly take note of that. Okay, so we're going to erase this one. So we have here now this general equation, no, b subscript o as our initial, no, as a function of x, y, times the partial derivative of your omega over with respect to x, plus b sub 1 as a function of x, y again, as times this partial derivative of omega with respect to y, is equal now to your r as a function of x and y. Okay, so this is now called the general first order linear partial, take note, partial differential equation with two independent variables. So as you can notice, no, these are now the independent variables, the x and your y. So that is why we have two independent variables, but our dependent variable is only one here, the omega. Okay, so linearity may be extended to partial differential equations, not only to ordinary differential equations. Okay, proceeding again, we have now this next slide. Linearity may be extended to partial differential equations of the form like this. So this is now our second order. Okay, from the previous, it's just a first order, but this time a second order. Okay, here second order because of this two. Okay, second order. So kindly familiarize this general equation, no, for the second order, general second order linear partial differential equation with two independent variables, no, this x and this y. Okay, So we will erase this one, no? So you have to be familiarized with this one. This is now our initial b as a function of x and y times the second partial derivative of your omega with respect to x, plus this b1 again as a function of x and y times the second partial derivative of omega with respect to x and y. For our third term, we have now this b subscript 2 as a function of x and y, partial derivative, second partial derivative of omega with respect now to y, plus this b subscript 3 as a function of x and y times the partial derivative of omega with respect to x, plus this b4 as a function of x and y, partial derivative of your omega with respect to y, plus the last term will be b5 as a function of x and y times the omega equal now to your r as a function of x and y. But sometimes this one, b sub o as a function of x and y, b sub 1 as a function of x and y, it does not necessarily connote that it should be a function, no, of both variables, no, x and y, but sometimes it's just a constant, no, it's just a function of maybe a constant and a single variable, but sometimes also both variables x and y. So it does not necessarily mean that if one is lacking here, only x and then no variable y, it doesn't follow with this general equation, but sometimes these two variables will appear and sometimes not. Maybe a constant and one variable, or sometimes both variables, okay? So proceeding, we have now this simple example, no, for linear and nonlinear determination, okay? So for number one, we have now this second derivative of y with respect to x plus 2b times this derivative of y with respect to x raised now to the power or exponent of 3 plus y is equal to 0. So what do you think? Is this equation linear or nonlinear? First, we are going to remember now that our general equation for this linear or nonlinear for ordinary differential equation is equal now to this b subscript o as a function of our x times your n derivative of y with respect to x to the n, plus the second is b1 as a function of x times your n minus 1 derivative of y with respect now to x raised to the n minus 1, plus until we got into this b subscript n minus 1 as a function of x times your dy over dx, plus our last is bn as a function of x times your y, okay, is equal now to r as a function of your x, okay? So this is now our original equation, no, based on the ordinary differential equation. So will this equation follows this general equation for linearity? So first we have here the second derivative, no, of y with respect to x. So here n, and here the next term is n minus 1. So n minus 1 is for this one, 2 minus 1 is single derivative. So single derivative dy over dx, no? So our b sub x here is just simply a constant, no? So just equal to 1, and the second term, our b sub 1 x is just equal now to this 2b. So in this one, Second derivative of y with respect to x, this complies with this term. And b sub o as a function of x is just simply 1 here. The second term is our b sub 1 as a function of x is 2b. And our n minus 1 derivative of y with respect to x raised to the n minus 1 is this one. Okay, so minus 1 is only 1 here, or the derivative of y with respect to x. But take note that you have this power or exponent, no, in which the derivative is being raised. So here, there's no such thing as this one. So that is why it does not comply with this general equation, no, of linearity of the ordinary differential equation. So therefore, we can say that this is linear or non-linear. This is non-linear. Okay? That is a non-linear. So how about with our number, okay, with this one. So we have here second derivative of y with respect to x plus this one minus 1 is the single here, so dy over dx minus until such it reaches to this dy over dx. No, our term here is just simply dy over dx here, and our b subscript n minus 1 as a function of x is just simply equal to 1. So our term here is b sub n as a function of x, y, this one, our y is just simply here, and our b sub n as a function of x is just simply equal to the constant 6, which is equal now to 0, where our r as a function of x is just simply equal to 0. So that is why I'm saying, no, that it does not really connote, no, that your r as a function of x is just a variable, no, it's just a function of a variable. Sometimes it's a constant, no, and sometimes it's a combination of constant and variable. Sometimes it's a constant only, or sometimes it's a function of a variable. So in this case, this one complies, no, this equation number 2 complies with the general equation for linearity for the ordinary differential equation. So therefore, we can say that this is linear. Okay, how about this number 3? This one. So second derivative, so our n here is just equal to 2, so 2 minus 1, so first derivative, where our b sub as a function of x here is just equal to x squared, and in this one, which is a first derivative, which is equivalent to this one, our b sub 1, b subscript n minus 1 as a function of x is just simply equal now to x, and our dy over dx is this one, the y prime, so it complies. How about the last term here? After the dy over dx is this y, so we have also y, and our b sub n as a function of x is just equal to this x squared minus n squared, and our r as a function of x is just simply equal now to 4x cubed. So therefore, we can say that this equation complies with this general equation, no, for linearity for this ordinary differential equation. So therefore, we can say that it is linear. Okay, so this is just a simple, no, example of determining the linear and non-linearity of an ordinary differential equation. Okay, so proceeding, we have now this next slide. Okay, this one. Number 1 here is the second derivative of x with respect to t plus t squared x is equal to 0. So first, is it an ordinary or partial differential or derivatives? So here you can say that this is an ordinary differential equation. Okay, so you can put here an ordinary, it is ordinary Okay. And next is we have this linear or nonlinear. So based on the general equation, no, of the linearity of the ordinary differential equation. So if this is our second derivative of x with respect to t, the next term should be this one, 2 minus 1 should be dx over dt. But we don't find here the dx over dt. So we can say that this is non-linear, okay? Non-linear. Next is the order. So what is now its order? So our highest order derivative here is second derivative. So therefore, we can say that it is second order. And now about the degree. So the exponent, no, the power of our highest order derivative is just raised to 1. So this, therefore, it is a first degree. Okay. Next, for our number 2 example, so we have here the second partial derivative of your omega with respect to t is just equal now to a squared times the second partial derivative of your omega with respect to time. So as you can observe on our previous slides, know that this one does not comply, no? This does not comply our general equation for the second derivative of your, or the partial second derivative of your omega. Since, if you can still remember, no, our general equation for that is simply equal now to this one, visible as a function of your xy, okay, times the second partial derivative of your omega over the partial derivative of your x, okay? And then the second one should be b sub 1 as a function of x and y again times the partial derivative of your omega, but this time with respect now to partial derivative of dx dy, okay? And the third term would be equal now to b subscript 2 as a function of x and y times the partial derivative, second partial derivative of your omega with respect now to your y. Okay? And the next term will be our b3 as a function of x and y. And then we have here the, okay, so excuse me, we will erase this one, no? As upon times the derivative of your partial derivative of your omega with respect now to 2x plus, again we have now this b4 as a function of xy times the partial derivative of your omega with respect now to y plus, and so on, no? If you can still recall. So by this one alone, this does not comply, no, with this condition or criterion of this partial differential equation. So therefore, we can say that this is first, this is partial differential equation, okay, and it is also non-linear. And in terms of the order, so it is a second order, and in terms of degree, it is a first degree, okay. So we are done with the number 2. So we will proceed with number 3. Okay, so we will erase this one. For our number 3, we have this y prime plus p as a function of xy is equals now to q as a function of x. Okay, so definitely this is a ordinary, okay, this is an ordinary differential equation. Okay, next, in terms of linear or non-linearity, it is linear, okay, because this is the first derivative, no, dy over dx plus as a function of y times the p as a function of x equals to q as a function of x. So this one follows the linearity requirement for this ordinary differential equation, so therefore it is linear. Okay, so how about its order? And this is also a first order, since this first derivative is just raised now to the 1, no, its exponent is 1, so it is a first order. Okay, and it is also a first order and first degree. Okay, for our next one is we have this number 4. So the second derivative, okay, so it is actually an ordinary, no, since it is dy over dx, no, this y double prime is just second derivative of y with respect to x, no, so it is an ordinary differential equation. How about the linearity or non-linearity? It is a non-linear, since this one, the second derivative, no, of your y with respect to x is raised now to this power or exponent of 3. If you can recall, no, the general equation for the linearity of an ordinary differential equation, so this does not comply with that general equation. So this is non-linear, okay? And how about its order? So the highest order is the second derivative, no? So it is second order, okay? And how about its degree? So its degree is, this is now the highest order, so it is raised to exponent of 3, okay? So this is third degree, okay? And for our last one, the number 5, we have also here ADE plus BDB is just equal to 0, so it is an ordinary differential equation, and consequently this is also a non-linear, and it is first order, and it is also a first degree. Okay, so I think that would be it, no, for this day. And next topic to be discussed, no, for my next lecture is we proceed with that of methods of solving the ordinary differential equation, no? So we have those separation of variables, and we have other methods also, no, for our next lecture. And then I think that would be it for this day, and thank you very much for listening and watching with regards now to these simple concepts and definitions and some exercises, no, regarding this differential equation course. And before we end, this is now my reference, Rinbel Earl D. within the elementary differential equations 8th edition. And please like, share, and subscribe for more updated videos for our subject differential equation. And thank you very much again for listening and watching, and God bless us all.